Samsung's second take on the Galaxy A3 could honestly be renamed the Galaxy S6 Mini because that's effectively what it is. Size differences aside, these two blows are close to identical from every angle. You get the same clean front, the same matte metallic edging, and that shiny glass back panel, which thankfully doesn't scuff up too noticeably on the darker models. Port and button positioning is the same too, and you'll even find the same jutting camera lens poking out of the rear. The Galaxy S6 was already quite comfortable to clutch compared to some of the bigger flagship phones, but the Galaxy A3's compact body is dead easy to use with just one mitt, no sweat. There's a decent heft to the dinky frame too, so it doesn't feel cheap or toy-like. And it's surprisingly rugged too, putting up with quite a bit of punishment, although a drop onto concrete could unfortunately spell its end. Ultimately, at this price point, there's very little to dislike about the Galaxy A3's design. Unlike the Galaxy S7, which was just launched, it isn't water resistant, but that's not something that we really miss. And while that camera lens does poke out a wee bit, it never really gets in the way. One feature that the Galaxy A3 thankfully doesn't share with the Galaxy S7 is a lack of expandable storage. Pop open the A3's SIM tray and you'll spot that there's a memory card slot, so you can slip in a microSD card and get bags of space for your media. That's great news if you like to get stuck into TV box sets on your commute. And sure, the Galaxy A3's 4.7-inch screen may be a bit dinky, but it's still perfectly fine for enjoying some telly on the go. It's a Super AMOLED display, obviously this being a Samsung device, so colours are richly reproduced. The powerful maximum brightness makes the A3 easy to view even in bright sunlight, and images are pleasingly crisp too. That 720p resolution gives almost the same pixel density as the iPhone SE. Of course, the tiny bottom-mounted speaker can't produce a very powerful sound, but audio quality is perfectly decent for kicking back with a YouTube video or two. Oh yeah, and you also get some perfectly okay earbuds bundled in the A3's box, which work in a pinch. The only big miss between the Galaxy A3 and Samsung's big flagship phones is the lack of a fingerprint sensor. That means you're resigned to tapping in a pin or a pattern every time you want to unlock your phone, unless of course you're happy to use Android's trusted devices and trusted places security tools. There's no heart rate sensor on the back of the A3 either, but as fat lazy bastards, we really couldn't care less. Android 5.1.1 comes pre-installed on the Galaxy A3, but we're hopeful that this will be updated to Marshmallow shortly. For now, Lollipop does the job, complete with Samsung's usual TouchWiz tweaks, including flipboards and an updated notifications bar. The interface is basically identical to the Galaxy S6's layout, which is no bad thing. One thing that Samsung hasn't tweaked compared to last year's Galaxy A3 is the processor that runs the show. The 2016 model still uses a Snapdragon 410 chipset, backed up by 1.5 GB of RAM. Thankfully, we didn't notice any stumbles or stutters when using the A3 for a full week, with apps loaded nice and quick. Gaming is also perfectly possible. We tried lots of different titles from the past few months and they all played with a decent frame rate. Just don't expect the performance to be quite as smooth in a year or two. Battery life is another serious highlight. You get close to 2 days on a single charge with restrained use, and well over a day with more regular use. Even non-stop video playback gives you around 9 to 10 hours of life, which is one of the best results that you'll see on a modern mobile. The A3's camera also holds up well against similarly priced rivals such as the OnePlus 2. Photos are packed with detail and boast realistic colours, and the HDR camera mode deals well with dodgy lighting, although low light scenes are a bit of a struggle. Even with the flash enabled, focusing often takes a couple of slightly blinding seconds. You can also shoot up to 1080p video, complete with image stabilisation to cut down on the jitters. And the 5-megapixel front-facing camera does a perfectly decent job of capturing that gorgeous mug of yours. Samsung's 2016 version of the Galaxy A3 is essentially a mini S6, boasting excellent battery life, clever optics, and a strong media experience, all wrapped up in a compact and gorgeous 4.7-inch package. If you want a mini mobile or simply can't afford Samsung's full-price flagship phones, the Galaxy A3 refresh will definitely do the job. For a full Galaxy A3 review and reviews of Samsung's other phones, check out recombu.com/mobile. Thanks for watching.